On the last day of October 2024, Airtable made an announcement about the API limitations for its free plans, but also helped to make it more concrete what those API limitations were for paid plans as well. In this video, I'm going to be breaking down what this means for you as an Airtable user. So if you are sending information to or from Airtable, you will want to explore this video to make sure you have a full grasp of the implications of the coming changes. If that's of interest to you, stick around and let's get into it. Welcome back to the channel. If you're new here, my name is Gareth. This is Gap Consulting, and it's our mission to help you unlock the full potential of your no-code tools. I'm talking about building and getting more organized than a simple spreadsheet could help you with, and also automating your processes so that you're not spending time on the repetitive tasks. Before we get into the heart of the video, I first want to invite you to join me for some free Airtable training. If you're new to Airtable, or if you've been a user for quite some time and you want to review the basics, grab my training at gapconsulting.io/airtable-crash-course. We'll send that training to you directly via email once you sign up there. But without further ado, let's hop on into my screen. I am starting here with the email that I received on October 31st, 2024. You can see I received this at 4 o'clock p.m. Mountain Time. And the title of this was Important Update, Changes to API Limits at Airtable. Now, in full transparency, I had heard some whispers about upcoming changes to API limits. I was not at liberty to discuss them at that time, but now that these emails have gone out publicly, it's time to talk about what the implications are of this. So let's jump in. First of all, I'm receiving this particular email because I'm on a free plan and I use the Airtable Web API. So if you're not on a free plan, or if you are not on a free plan that uses the Web API, then there's a good chance you didn't receive this email. Can you still learn something from this? Absolutely. We're going to dive into the pricing in general, but most specifically, the people who are most directly impacted, at least from this email, are going to be those free plan users who are using the API. So moving on in the email, we have an important update to share with you regarding changes to the API usage limits on the free plan. Now, again, we've heard from Airtable in early 2024 that there were going to be some pricing implications against the API, which means if you're sending information to or from Airtable, maybe you're talking to Zapier, Make, Softr, Stacker, NoLoco. I mean, there are so many different tools you could be integrating with. Document, Docs Automator. All of these require that you're sending information to or from Airtable to this other tool. So if you're doing that, and there's a great chance that you are, then this will have an impact on you. Basically, what this means is you are sending information or retrieving information into Airtable. And every time you do that, you are using that API. So scrolling on down a little bit further in the email, what changes are we making? They are going to begin to block calls over the API limits on the free plan starting December 2nd. So if you're watching this video in November 2024, when we publish it, this is not going to impact you immediately, but it will within a very short amount of time. What are those changes? Well, they're making this change because they've learned that a relatively small number of customers on the free plan are the heaviest users of the API, far exceeding the number of calls that the vast majority of customers make on a monthly basis. Instead of raising prices to accommodate this usage, we are limiting API calls to manage costs for both customers and for Airtable. So let's have a quick chat about what this really means. And first and foremost, I want to start by saying that I have been hearing this type of messaging from many of the different software platforms in the no-code space. Namely, that some of the free accounts are actually using the highest amount of API calls. So essentially what this means is there are some folks who have learned how to kind of game the system. They log in, create a free account, in this case in Airtable or in another no-code tool, and then they just spam the heck out of the API. So they don't actually wind up paying anything to Airtable. They're totally using this for free, and yet they're clearly sending a lot of data back and forth. So before we get really irate about the fact that these API restrictions or limitations are being now published and pushed down on the free plan, let's also remember the fact that if we are, in fact, using API calls this frequently, we're clearly doing a lot of heavy lifting. At that stage, is it not fair that you would maybe pay to be on an Airtable upgraded plan? I know I might get some heat for that. That might not be a popular opinion. But as Airtable said here in the email, they're limiting this to manage costs for customers and for Airtable. They don't want to have to pass these costs down to everybody. So instead, they're saying, look, you can still have a free plan. We're just going to limit the amount of data you can send. And if you're really leaning into it and using a ton of API calls, then you can probably afford to bump up a tier and get on a paid plan in Airtable. Bear in mind that in most use cases, if you're on a free plan and you upgrade, provided that you only have one user, it's a $24 a month upgrade. So if you're really sending that much data, if it's that integral a part of your business where you're using over the API usage limits, you can probably squeeze out that little upgrade. Okay, so here's what we can expect though. Moving down into the next part, you are currently using the API within the new limit. So this is for my particular account, the email that I got. I'm not exceeding the 1,000 API calls on my free Airtable plan. And so it says you're not affected by the change unless in the future you go over the limit. Okay, you are now able to see the number of API calls utilized in your workspace settings. This is big news for everybody. I'm talking about pro users, enterprise users, all of the folks who are on those upgraded plans. I don't even remember the names of the plans anymore because I feel like they've changed so frequently. But we can flip into our workspace settings, and this is actually going to take me directly to my Airtable workspace and particularly inside of my free plan. So here on the left-hand side, we see all the different plans that we have. These are our different workspaces, and if you're new to Airtable, a workspace is really just a folder for databases, but each workspace has its own users and its own plan, its own paid or not paid plan. So in this particular one, I have something called Airtable Automation Accelerator, which is an old course that we used to sell at Gap Consulting. And you can see that we're not making any calls. So this visibility right here, where my cursor is, 0 out of 1,000 public API calls per month. This is brand new information that none of us could see previously. Now, I don't necessarily feel that it is 100% accurate in its reporting yet, because here I am flipping into Gap Consulting. And inside of my Gap Consulting, we use this a ton. We're sending all kinds of automations to Zapier, to Softr, to NoLoco. We are talking to all kinds of software. And as you can see right here, we have 902 API calls. I'm not sure exactly when this started counting, but I'm a little surprised at how low this number is. So I'm definitely going to keep my eye on this. I don't think we're going to exceed 100,000 calls inside of our team plan, that is the $20+ a month tier that we're on. I don't think we're going to exceed 100,000 calls, but I do want to keep my eye on it in the future now that this number is available, because again, previously it was not. So then the last place that I want to take our attention to is to Airtable pricing. You can go to airtable.com/pricing to take a look at the API call limitation per month. Now, this has been available for a while, but again, we didn't have visibility into the number of calls we were making until just the other day. So here we are, API calls, free plan, 1,000, team plan, 100,000, business and enterprise scale, unlimited. So this is actually a really meaningful metric for us that we at Gap Consulting are going to keep our eyes on. This may mean that we have to upgrade to that business level plan because of API usage as we continue to leverage APIs more and more. Remember, every time you send information externally using a third-party tool, Zapier, Make, N8N, NoLoco, Stacker, Softr, Docs Automator, Document, I mean, the list goes on and on. Anywhere that you are sending information from Airtable outside, there's a good chance you're doing an API call with that. make sure to watch your usage. That's it for this video. I know that this is a little bit technical and we really didn't build anything. We're just talking about the changes to pricing and the new implications that that has. But if you have any questions we did not actually address, feel free to swing by the website and get some assistance. Of course, if you found value in this video, don't forget to thumbs up and subscribe to the channel. But most importantly, my friend, keep on building.